Four turnovers, a blocked punt, and a 33% third down conversion rate told the story on Saturday as Illinois thumped Indiana 27-14 at the Big Ten opener in Bloomington.
That's the number one thing we talk about all the time. We were plus six going into the game, and we had four turnovers. I mean, that eventually is going to get you, and we had a punt blocked. Those are things that we've got to, go back and correct.
I mean, it was a huge difference with all the turnovers throughout the entire game. Two of them was down in the red zone. Cost us a couple of points. We wasn't used to that. I mean, it's just adversity that we had to deal with, see what we done wrong, and just come back next week and hopefully get a victory against Iowa.
There's 11 guys on the offensive ball, offensive side of the ball, that are responsible for that ball. So a turnover by one guy is a turnover by 11 guys. I think if we hadn't turned the ball over, especially given the field position that we turned it over in sometimes, we would have had a lot better shot today.
Although the Indiana defense limited Illinois to just 7 second half points, they had difficulty maintaining the rush all afternoon as Rashard Mendenhall picked up 214 yards en route to nearly 300 Illini rush yards.
When you try to stop Mendenhall, he's a Big Ten running back. He's classic Big Ten. He's a tough guy. And if you stop him, then you got have to worry about Juice throwing it or passing it.
We didn't play well enough to win, and we'll get that corrected, but it's just one game. And there's a lot of football left, and we'll learn from it and learn from some of the situations we were in today that we haven't been in. And we'll go back to work, and we're getting ready to go to Iowa.
So ultimately, sloppy play the difference in this ball game as Indiana loses 27-14 to Illinois, snapping a two-game winning streak against the Illini. With the loss, the Hoosiers dropped to 3-1 on the year. Reporting with the Hoosiers in Bloomington, I'm Ronan O'Shea, your Palestra reporter at Indiana University.